gusto ko
pero, pero, so, ito,
mangyayari siguro
sa akin,
kahit gumawa na kayo, mauna na kayo ng order, okay, tapos, siyempre tayo siguro yung tapos, pakit ka rin lang sa ating output video.
Yung talaga yung nakakasin,
ano ba? Nakakompare namin ito.
Sinihirap ako.
Okay, okay. Sakit lang sa side. Tayo, sa ilo mo, sa ilo mo, mabalik kita.
Ano?
Tapos pakita nyo na lang sa amin yung feeling nito para tayo sa
sige mga mga
mag-ato na lang siguro mga 3 o'clock.
Okay, this is the first
sana. Play natin. Nandito tayo ngayon sa Lord's Feet ng Divine Mercy Church. Ayun! Yun, so, pakita natin yung video na classmate. Ayusin na lang natin yung sasya sa inyo.
Sabi niya, malapit na daw siya dito eh.
Kontakin mo kaya para malaman natin.
Hanapin muna natin.
Ito na pala yung Manila Cathedral eh.
Para lapit tayo. Tara,
nakita natin.
Hintayin nyo na dito si Victor. Pupuntahan ko lang si May sa San Agustin Church.
Sige.
Yeah. Ano kaya yung simbahan? Kaya ayos ito.
Ano
pa ba kayo nandito?
Oo.
Eh, traffic kasi dun sa... Asa nga pala si Jocelyn? Ba't yung kasama?
Sinundo si May.
Ah... O, total na dito naman na tayo sa Manila Cathedral eh. Tungkol dun sa gagawin nating movie sa Art Appreciation. Gusto nyo ba marinig yung nakakuha ko? Kasi ganito yun.
On January 24, 1571, Feast of St. John the Baptist, the Spanish conquistador Miguel Lopez de Legazpi founded the city of Manila. He earlier took possession of Maynilad, the native settlement of Raja Matanda and Raja Sulaiman, on May 19, 1571, and firmly established Spanish authority in the newly conquered and untrammeled turf. The historic day happened to be the Feast of Santa Potenciana, and to honor her, she was made patroness of the new territory. Armed with the Spanish sword and the cross, Legazpi, in his role as conquistador, apportioned a parcel of land for the church of the new settlement under the patronage of La Purísima Inmaculada Concepción. The Church of Manila was established by the secular Juan de Vivero, who had the honor of baptizing Raja Matanda. Vivero first arrived in these shores in 1566 as chaplain of the Nó, or galleon of San Jerónimo, which had come to support the Spanish colonization of the newly discovered islands. He was given the special privilege and sole faculty by the Archbishop of Mexico to establish the spiritual administration of the new Philippine colony. Later, Vivero would become the first vicar general and the first ecclesiastical judge of Manila.
Ayun, so yun yung nakuha kong research tungkol sa history ng Manila Cathedral.
Ah, ganun pala yun.
Kayo ba? May nakuha kayong ano?
Nung isang araw, nag-research kaming dalawa. Ang nabasa ko namin tungkol sa Manila Cathedral ay...
The Church of Our Lady of the Immaculate Conception administered the religious affairs of Manila until such time it became a parish and Manila was created into a diocese. It was a simple structure of nipa and bamboo materials which were readily available during that time. It had for its first parish priest, the secular Juan de Villanueva. The other religious who became the pillars of this parish were Juan de Vivaneta and Nicolas Riccio.
This church was also witness to the events that would threaten the city and its residents. On November 30, 1574, the feast of St. Andrew the Apostle, the Spanish forces was able to quell Limahong's invasion. Because of such fortunate turn of events, the Holy Apostle was made patron saint of Manila. The victory was celebrated with fireworks, and the mass with sermon was held in the Church of Our Lady of the Immaculate Conception in Manila.
Ganun pala yun. Ayun, so may isang church na tayo. Punta tayo kala Diyosis sa kakaimi.
Tara. Tayo naman nun.
Punta tayo po.
Uy, maampun na.
Ayan.
Dito na tayo.
Ano pala yun?
Asan sila Josie at me?
Sabi lang, itayin daw natin sila dito sa harapan eh.
Hey, teka lang, kukunin ko lang yung camera para mapag-start na tayo.
Sige. Tara na.
Payo. Payo.
The first San Agustin Church was the first religious structure constructed by the Spaniards on the island of Luzon. Made of bamboo and nipa, it was completed in 1571 but destroyed by fire in December 1574 during the attempted invasion of Manila by the forces of Limahong. A second church made of wood was constructed on the site. This was destroyed in February 1583 in a fire that started when a candle set ablaze the drapes of the funeral bier during the interment of Spanish Governor General Gonzalo Ronquillo de Peñalosa. The Augustinians decided to rebuild the church using stone and to construct an adjacent monastery. Construction began in 1583, based on the design by Juan Masha. The structure was built using hewn adobe stones quarried from Maycawayan, Binangonan, and San Mateo Rizal. The work proceeded slowly due to the lack of funds and materials, as well as the relative scarcity of stone artisans.
Tapos yung, nung kumasok sa loob, naobserbahan ko yung architectural style niya, ganito.
The church measures around 68 meters long and 25 meters wide. The oviform foundation has enabled the construction to withstand legion of earthquakes that destroyed other churches in Manila. The original design is almost a perfect copy of Puebla Cathedral, or the Augustinian Church in Mexico. Granite sculptures of lions decorated the courtyards. They are gifts from Chinese converts to Catholics. The austere facade has little touches of Baroque, especially the flowery carvings on its wooden doors. The interior of the church takes the form of Latin cross, which has 14 side chapels with different saints and art decors. Italian artists Cesare Alberoni and Giovanni di Bella painted the ceiling in 1875. The hand-carved 17th century Molavi wood, a tropical hardwood, is an eye-catching which furnishes the choir attic.
Ayun,
edi
main church tayo. Itayin na natin si Kevin sa camera na dala-dala niya, tapos shoot natin dito.
Sige.
Magkatapos ito sa Manila Katapos.
Sige, tara.
Sabay-sabay na para.
Tapos edit na lang. Kasama na yung isa ibang grupo natin.
Okay.
Teka, teka. Eh, puro
kayo history nung ano eh, nung church na to eh.
Teka lang ulit. Ito kami ngayon.
Let's go.
Play natin.
I'm gonna die.
I'm gonna die.